Yes.
The headlines. Press. Sorry.
Well, we're going to start with the new Mossad head, Yossi Cohen, as we saw on Monday evening, was appointed by the Prime Minister. Yesterday he came out with a short message saying that he wants to thank the Prime Minister for his trust in me. I am very excited about the significance of this nomination. Who is Yossi Cohen? We have a profile about him. I think it's a good time to show our viewers who exactly this man
is. Mossad head.
Let's check it out.
As the head of one of the most prestigious intelligence agencies in the world, there are not many opportunities to get emotional or excited. The only proper time is probably when you say your hellos or make your farewells. But Yossi Cohen, the newly announced Mossad chief, allowed himself to get carried away by the moment before dropping from sight for a few years, away from the public eye.
I am very thrilled from the magnitude of this event and the importance of the nomination. It's an important organization. I tend to do my utmost, good operations, to bring good intelligence to the people of Israel, to do it quietly, modestly, and with confidence.
Cohen, a.k.a. the Model, is a Mossad veteran who served as the deputy director of the agency between 2011 and 2013. Then he took up the post that probably was the key step to his new appointment, the National Security Advisor of Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. There are no doubts when it comes to Cohen's vast knowledge and experience in the secret world. He served in the agency for 3 decades and headed the high-esteemed Tzomet department, in charge of recruiting and operating agents and informers abroad. Under him, the division received a respected Israel Defense Prize, according to experts, for successful performance and achievements related to Iranian affairs. Cohen's hands-on professionalism was highly enriched during his time as the head of the National Security Council. There, he gained experience in international diplomacy and politics, namely his recent heading of the sensitive dialogue with Washington over the nuclear deal with Iran. But to this impressive resume, an important fact can be added. The very, very good terms Cohen has with the Netanyahu family, most significantly, Sarah Netanyahu. Netanyahu's relations with the two previous heads of Mossad, Tamir Pardo and Meir Dagan, were not very good, maybe even troubled. Dagan even became rival of sorts to Netanyahu, following their substantially conflicting perspectives on the Iranian threat and the ways to handle it. Those tensions culminated earlier this year when he was the keynote speaker at a rally calling to change the government. But Cohen's case is different. To begin with, his worldview tallies close to Netanyahu's. And while serving as head of the NSC, his relations with the Netanyahu family were strengthened, given the Prime Minister's past experience with heads of Mossad. This is highly important for the days ahead.
Okay, that's our new guy.
What do you think? Is he
looking
good there?
Time will tell and who he hires.
He doesn't wear a bow tie, I'll tell you that.
He doesn't wear a bow tie.
Anyway, Israeli-Swedish relations seem to be getting just worse and worse and worse. This time, stuff that the Prime Minister, Stefan Löfven, said. And he claimed yesterday in a local interview with local media that the knife attacks that are happening now in Israel are not orchestrated by a terror group, and that's why they do not meet the international definition of terror. Okay. This is coming on the heels of the Swedish foreign minister saying stuff.
Yeah.
Very, very...
And I'm amazed that nobody on the Israeli side has faulted them, Sweden, for IKEA. But... Yeah, I'm sorry.
Right.
That would be, damn
you. You were talking about Donald Trump earlier in the first segment. There are a lot of course, comparisons of what he's doing to things from the past, for example, Nazism.
Right.
One newspaper in the United States, a local Philly newspaper, this is the Philadelphia Daily News, really went all the way, took it all the way home.
Wow.
Look at this headline, the Daily News, the new Führer. Which sounds exactly, of course, like Führer,
and the
arm extended out like a Heil Hitler.
See, do we think this is the end of his political career?
Wow. I do not know. There are some rumors running around that he might actually try
be ousted out of
the Republican Party or might leave on his own accord.
Yeah.
The polls are showing that he's not yet being hurt by what he's doing yet. In fact, maybe just the opposite.
Maybe just the opposite.
But,
that would be interesting.
We will have to
see.
And just a quick follow-up on what we talked about yesterday with Yemen. We mentioned that there was going to be a ceasefire. You and I were both very skeptical about this thing.
Exactly.
I just want to say that the president, Abid Rabu Mansour Hadi, sent a letter to the UN, says, yes, we will have a UN ceasefire from December 7th to the 15th, 7 days. So as opposed to other ceasefires, this seems something like there's a bit more of a buildup to it.
Right.
And it seems a bit more serious. But like you said yesterday, I am skeptical, you are skeptical.
Is Ali skeptical?
I am skeptical, yes.
Ali is skeptical as well. Ami.